sometimes it's difficult also if somebody gets a really high grasp underneath the arm to get out. That gives you an ability to trap the arm and bind it a little bit more, which means easier takedowns if you're doing this type of work. It's a little more difficult to get out from the actual hook of the fingers to get down into this type of position. Not impossible. Some of the things that help open that up are you're sitting here working shoulder shot. That little hit to the shoulder will cause them to forget about their hand for a second, and that allows you to go from this higher position and pushing it down. Now, I often will not go like this. I will not put my hand up here if it's really high, because then it puts me at a disadvantage. He'll just use that as a hook to turn me and throw me over on my back. So I can't sit there and use that because that's giving him leverage. So I try to keep it down, and if I'm gonna do anything, what I'll do is I'll push here and I'll just use my shoulder and I'll keep binding. What I'll do is I'll work from this position, pressing down here, reposition, reposition, and reposition. Now remember, that's the entire time that we're doing that, I'm also struggling here and struggling to get positional changes and things like that. So it'll make it a little easier. If it were me just going like this and just trying to do this in a static position, it's much more difficult. But since we're not, remember, I'm gonna use this till I get it to the position. I scrape it down with my elbow and forearm, and then I'll get to this break point. Now, to open up the break point on somebody who's really strong like Dave, you have to take how the fingers open themselves and you want to move them to that position. So you'll see how he's hooking here. So what I do momentarily and temporarily is I'll go from this position, I'll open him up, and then that'll help cause the disconnect. So I open up, all while I'm pushing down here. So all while this is going on, I'll do a little break, little lightness of being, so to speak, on this here. I won't put too much pressure on it. As I work this, then I'll switch it. So my coming back with my hips make that happen. You cannot stay in this position too long, because he'll headbutt you, he'll throw punches from the other side, whatever else you happen to be doing. So this is a very simple, quick movement. You reinsert and you've got that. And then when I switch out, I get to this position. The really important part about this is you have to use a little bit of silat in this. And silat is, I'm going to direct them. I'm going to move them in a position that changes the structure of the base. I make them take a step. And this is going through here like this. I use the phrase of looking to the future. So if you're going to do that pose, you know, we're all looking to the future, you got to have the hand going up to the future, right? Future is generally up. If I'm going down like this, for some people maybe not, but if I'm going down like this, and I expect him to go towards his post much easier. What I'm trying to do on this particular move for Silat and taking that step is going up underneath the armpits, so you can see how the shoulder linkage moves. And what I'm doing is I'm trying to lift just a little bit up here. The closer I get to shoulder loading him, basically shelf loading here, makes it a little more advantageous for my delt muscles to lift that type of a weight. If I'm out here on this end trying to do it, it's really hard. So what I do is I get up underneath here. Now I got a lot. I got a lot of power. This, combined with a little downward pressure, moves him to take a step. And his base is lighter. As soon as I make him take that step, then I switch it out. This hand will come down here to the top. My shoulder, in this manner, will go like this. Think of yourself in the Superman or superhero pose. You actually want to cross like that. It's one of the few times that we'll work the crossing center line. So when I'm out like this, I go through here, posting. Shoulder comes in and it'll go down. The problem people have is they'll get up to here. For one, they'll go down here and it won't work as well. Then from here, what they'll do sometimes is they'll go forward to where he would naturally post. And like I said, if I go towards where he would naturally post, let's say he puts his hand down, he's safe. But if you look at where I'm going to send him, I'm going to go like this. Even if he were to post temporarily, my movement here puts him toward a position of non-post in a declination or continually going downward and having him, he cannot keep that post up. When this motion comes through here, we take this position. I'm gonna put him back over here where my foot is.